Abby, one would expect the reaction from a White House to be something along the lines of the Russian election interference is unacceptable. We're going to bring this up with President Putin. It can't be allowed to happen again. Thank you to Mueller and to Rosenstein for bringing this attention to the public. What did the White House say today?
Well, that's right, Jake. You would expect the White House to say something along those lines, but it was notable for as much as it didn't say, especially about the indictments and about the allegation that the Russian military or officers within it were involved in this attack on America. The White House spokeswoman, Lindsay Walters, released a statement that paraphrased some of what Rod Rosenstein said in his press conference, specifically the parts about how the allegation don't specifically implicate any Americans wittingly in any of this. She says there was no allegation that in the indictment that Americans knew they were corresponding with Russians, no allegation that any American citizen committed a crime, and no allegation that the conspiracy changed the vote count or affected the election. But she does say this: today's charges include no allegation of knowing involvement by anyone in the campaign and no allegations that the alleged hacking affected the election results. This is consistent with what we have said all along. It seems very much so from that statement, Jake, that the White House is trying to vindicate President Trump.
The indictment does mention somebody who did speak with, and it might have been unknowingly, but did speak with Russian military intelligence officers and then talked to senior officials of the Trump campaign. So this isn't necessarily over. It might be, but it isn't necessarily over. And I mean, where, as Bob Dole once said, where is the outrage?
First of all, there isn't any outrage. I mean, this is, if there's such a thing as a narcissistic White House, official White House statement, this is it. This is about Donald Trump saying, see, we didn't do anything wrong. I didn't do anything wrong. Where in the statement was a congratulations to the Justice Department for all of its hard work and its forensic work, which is quite stunning if you read the indictment, in bringing forth his indictment.
Right. It's not like they can just walk into Russian military intelligence officers and interrogate them.
I mean, I know nothing about this, but I can only imagine what it was like because they're quoting from the emails that they clearly got or the text messages. Where is the President of the United States saying, you know, we have to find a way to make sure that this does not occur again? This is cyber war, and we have to defend ourselves. Instead, we got this self-serving statement from the President of the United States, and you point out that, particularly in Section 44 of this indictment, it's not just American citizens here. These are people who work for or around the Trump campaign that they are quoting their emails, one of which really struck me. It said, what do you think from Guccifer 2.0?
But Guccifer is actually Russian military intelligence officers, but
pretending
to be a hacker.
With someone who was in contact with regular members of the campaign. What do you think of the information on the turnout model for the Democrats' entire presidential campaign? The answer was pretty standard, but it was answered.
Very interesting. Now, you worked for Bob Mueller, and he is the one behind the presentation of information to the grand jury. The grand jury then indicts, and Rod Rosenstein and the prosecutors go on from there. What struck you looking at this indictment?
So what I think Mueller has given us now is part two, Jake. Part one was the social media campaign, and we saw an elaborate indictment against 11 organizations and individuals who use social media to impact the voter perceptions. Now we have part two, which is the hacking of computers, obtaining emails, distributing those emails in an effort to impact the voter outcome. So Mueller has told us, here's how they did it. Part one, part two. Now, National Security Division will take that part over in the Justice Department, and Mueller will look, I think, in respect of both part one and part two, were any individuals connected with the Trump campaign knowingly involved in these activities. He hasn't said nothing about that yet. He's just said people were in contact, but he didn't say whether they did so knowingly. And I think that's where Mueller will turn while the National Security Division takes over these prosecutions.
Jennifer Rogers, let me bring you in here. What was your response to the indictment?
Well, I thought similar to Michael that we've been expecting this indictment. We knew that there were crimes involving the Russians with respect to the hacking and distribution and also the hacking into the state electoral processes. So it's not a surprise to see that. You know, I think that they have already, of course, been looking at whether any Americans were involved. And if they had the goods, they would have charged it here. But there still is work to do. We know that they've been in talks with Roger Stone and some people around him about talking to the special counsel. So I do think they have continued investigation to do. We may see a superseding indictment, but I don't know that they really have held off on that piece. I think they've been trying to do it, you know, kind of as things come up. It's just a little bit slower, and the Trump camp has not been particularly forthcoming in terms of providing witnesses and at least some information. So I think they are continuing to work in that regard.
Jennifer, what can the Justice Department do here? Obviously, these Russian military intelligence officers aren't going to fly in from the Kremlin and say, here I am, I'm ready for my day in court. I mean, they're not going to actually face any charges, really, are they?
They can do two things. One thing is, of course, if they do end up traveling to a country that is friendly with the U.S., they can be scooped up that way. They probably will not be stupid enough to do that, but it's at least a possibility. The other thing is the president really should be pressing Putin to turn them over. I mean, this is a huge, obviously, attack on our country and interference in our elections. I don't think he will do that. I think we all know, given the posture he's taken so far, that's not going to happen. But that's really what should be happening here.
Now, in terms of what the president is going to do when he sees Putin on Monday, we should remember that Deputy Attorney General Rosenstein, when he gave his press conference, noted that he had briefed President Trump on these indictments that were likely to come down. Now, knowing that, I want you all to take a listen to President Trump this morning giving a joint press conference with British Prime Minister Theresa May, talking about the Mueller investigation that he knew was about to result in the indictments of 12 Russian military intelligence officers for hacking into DNC and Hillary Clinton emails, distributing that information, and interfering with the election. Take a listen.
I think that we're being hurt very badly by the I would call it the witch hunt. I would call it the rigged witch hunt. I think that really hurts our country, and it really hurts our relationship with Russia. I think that we would have a chance to have a very good relationship with Russia and a very good relationship with President Putin.
So it would seem that President Trump believes that the issue here is not the cyber attack by the Russians on the United States, but the U.S. Justice Department and the special counsel investigation into that cyber attack. Right. That's the only thing you can glean from that.
Exactly. He thinks the issue is Mueller and not Putin. And he knew. I mean, what makes it worse is the Justice Department briefed him on this. And the other day, if you recall, he mentioned to reporters, I'm going to ask your favorite question about meddling. And then he said it all today, as if he were just dismissive of it. And he knew this. And it just doesn't make any sense. His Justice Department has presented him with incontrovertible evidence here and a grand jury indictments of key Putin advisors, aides, military men, intelligence officers who wouldn't do any of this without the permission and the encouragement of Vladimir Putin. And it's just stunning that he would be so dismissive of Mueller's work.